Hi, I'm David Spearman. I'm the videographer at the Ron Clark Academy. So your students have been sorted into houses and are busy earning house points. Let's talk about how to create the photos and the videos that are displayed on the school kiosk each time they earn those points. Right now, I'm going to give you a couple of pointers on how I personally shoot and edit this meeting. Now, some of you creators may already be familiar with photo and video editing and just need to know the required dimensions and specifications. So check out this information on the screen. This should get you headed in the right direction. Now, at the least, you'll need to create a photo for each student. But if you want to create a little bit more magic, as we like to do here at RCA, you can additionally capture an 8-second video for each student to show up on the kiosk when they get those points. So what equipment do I use? I use a Sony mirrorless DSLR. But to be honest, these days you can really get away with a smartphone. So where should you take these photos? Outside? In a photo studio? Well, that's up to you. If you want to shoot on a white background, or maybe even put the house colors in the background, you can get as simple or as creative as you like. However, I do encourage you to do what we do here at RCA, which is take it a step further and digitally replace the background of the photo or video with special standardized colors used throughout the House Points app. This gives everything, all the colors, a clean and consistent look. So my setup for shooting pictures and video is fairly simple. I have the students stand about 6 to 8 feet in front of the background. I try to evenly light the background, and if this sounds complicated, you can just find a plain white wall in a well-lit area, which works out just fine. Next, light the student in a soft and even light. And for all my photographers and cinematographers out there, you can use a key light, a fill light, a rim light, a kicker, a scrim, a bounce. For everybody else who doesn't have access to all that equipment, just make sure that the student is well-lit and from the waist up, because that'll be the framing, waist up. Now hold your camera in the vertical position and leave room above the head and around the limbs of the student. No part of the student should be outside the top or sides of the frame. And so after you've taken the picture, now you're ready to open it up in a photo editor to adjust the dimensions of the photo to 480 by 574 pixels. Write those dimensions down somewhere. It's going to be useful for both photo and video. And if you don't have a fully featured photo editing app such as Photoshop installed on your computer, there are a number of online tools such as Clidio.com that you can use to resize your photos and videos without too much of a hassle. Like I said before, we recommend that you replace the background with one of the standard house colors. Background replacement is where an app like Photoshop comes in clutch. Here are the numerical values for the colors. Now, the last thing to do is to export as a 480 by 574 pixel JPEG, and that is it. All right, moving on to video. 8 seconds is all we need. It's basically the same framing and lighting as the photo setup. The background color and design is up to you. But if you want to replace the background with the standard house app colors, you'll need to shoot on a green screen or a blue screen. And very important for video, please use a tripod. Unlike photo capture, it's very important that your camera remain completely still throughout the video. Or else if the student is moving and the camera is moving, everything is moving, it just doesn't work out as well. The only thing that should be moving is the student within the frame. They should start and end within the frame. And make sure that no part of the student, the head, the shoulders, knees, or toes, ever leaves the frame for the full 8 seconds. The movements of the student during the 8 seconds should be smooth and minimal, less is more, as the final video will keep looping over and over again on the kiosk. Nothing too big. Folded arms and a smile and nod is a go-to classic. You can also have the students slightly shift weight from one foot to the other, but you gotta be careful that they don't move too quickly or out of the frame. You'll probably spend a lot of time on that one, so be prepared to do it a few times. It's normal. In the end, encourage the students to just be themselves. You want them to look and feel natural in their moment to shine on the leaderboard. So that's the concept for the basic 8-second video. But now for a little bit more magic, let's move on to the advanced 8-second video. Because of the video looping feature on the kiosk, you know how I said the video will be looping over and over again? We have the option of creating a cool seamless effect where there's seemingly no beginning or end to the video. Take a look at these two clips so we can see the differences side by side. All right, after 8 seconds, the basic one on the left jumps back to the beginning, but the advanced video on the right reverses to the beginning, and then at the beginning it reverses to the end, and so on and so forth. Seamless. It looks like magic. So here's a few pointers on how to achieve that look. All we need to record is 4 seconds of posing instead of 8 seconds. We'll take that 4 seconds, duplicate it, and reverse it to form 8 seconds. And if you don't follow me, it'll make a little bit more sense as I explain it. For the movements, it's important that the student starts and ends their movement within that 4-second time frame. Slow movements look best. Pro tip, I used a metronome app to count out those 4 seconds. And here's a little demonstration of how of what that looks like.
6, 7, 8, move. 1, 2, 3, stop. 4, perfect. Got it, that's all.
Make sure that they come to a smooth stop at the end, not abrupt. No wiggling or moving past the 4 count, or else it will look unnatural when it transitions from forward to backwards. All right, so whether you created a basic or advanced video, we need to take the clip into a video editor to adjust it to 480 by 574 and export as an MP4. So the basic video, the 8-second video, all you need to do is clip the beginnings and the ends, and you're done. But for the advanced seamless effect, let me give you a closer look at what I'm doing in Premiere Pro. Now, I'm using Premiere Pro, but the same general principles apply in editors such as Final Cut Pro or DaVinci Resolve. And pro tip, make sure you set your sequence settings to a multiple of 480 by 574 so you can adjust the framing accordingly. All right, here's the 4-second clip. Here I'll duplicate it and place it to the side, and here I'll reverse it and make it go backwards. If I loop it, it looks like this. That works, right? So editors, if you've shot on a green screen or a blue screen, here is where you will replace it with the standard House app colors. And again, here are those numerical values for the background colors, which you can also find online at rcahousepoints.com. Now to export as a 480 by 574 MP4 clip, and we are done. So thank you for watching and following along. I hope you found this video helpful and are fired up and ready to create this magic for your students. And I hope to see you all at the next RCA House Conference.